No long intros, let's get straight to the point. This video is inspired by Austin McConnell's series on useless information videos. Go check them out, link is in the description. Please subscribe and let's get into it. The Prague metro is powered by a third rail, whereas the trams and trains are powered by an overhead line. On multiple occasions, people have tried to play subway surfers in real life and have run into the metro tunnels, causing hours-long interruptions of service. There are three metro depots in Prague, one in Kačerov, one in Zličín, and one in Hostivař. There was a proposed metro line extension to the Václav Havel airport, but that was shelved in favor of a train line from Prague Masaryk train station. A high-speed rail line in Prague is slated for completion in 2033. It is supposed to lead to Brno, the second largest city in the Czech Republic, and Ostrava, the third largest city. With the nature of big construction projects in this country, I'd be surprised if it gets completed before the sun explodes. The Prague Public Transit Company donated some of its older tram and bus models to the Ukrainian cities of. Speaking of Ukraine, a tram painted in the Ukrainian colors is going around the city, with a QR code linking to a donation website. This serves as a mobile aneurysm dispenser to all the Putin meat riders in the city. The westernmost tram stop in Prague is Sídliště Řepy, in the Řepy district. The easternmost tram stop is Lehovec. The trams are popular advertising spaces, with numerous companies plastering full vehicle ads over them. There is a plan to bring trams back to the front of Prague main train station, with the track going through the infamous Vychlického Sady Park, or as Czechs like to call it, Sherwood. The park is infamous for being full of homeless people, drug addicts and drunks at night. It's an absolutely great place to be. The Prague metro doesn't run 24/7. The last metro that runs every day goes at 5 minutes past midnight on the B line from Černý most to Zličín. In comparison, the first metro that leaves every day is on the A line from Nemocnice Motol to Depo Hostivař, leaving at 4:41 AM. The public transit stop consisting of the most words is Park Maxe van der Stoele, named after Max van der Stoel, a Dutch politician that was the first Western politician to contact Charta 77. Charta 77 was an initiative that basically went something like this. A full M1 metro train, which runs on the C line, has 224 seats and up to 1240 spaces for standing passengers, assuming a density of 8 standing passengers per square meter. This is often achieved after big sports games and concerts. Anyone who has been to Letňany after someone like Imagine Dragons plays there can confirm. The other metro train model, which runs on the A and B line, called the 8171M, has 220 seats and 1,086 spaces for standing passengers. This means that the 8171M has a combined capacity of 1,306 passengers per metro train. This is the Tatra R1, the first prototype train for the Prague metro. It was supposed to be manufactured in the Čekáde Praha Smíchov factory. Unfortunately, after a few accidents and potential meddling from the USSR, it was decided that the Prague metro would use older, technologically inferior HAS trains. These trains were manufactured in the Mytyshchinsky Mashinostroitelny Zavod factory near Moscow. The smallest delay acknowledged by the Czech railways is 5 minutes, anything less than that is not shown in the train station. Speaking of delays, the Czech Railways say that in 2022, the trains arrived on time 88.8% of the time. Sometimes I find that hard to believe, but okay. The political party Praha Sobě floated around an idea for a circular metro line for Prague, like the Balshaya Kolcevaya line in Moscow or the Circle line in London. The proposed name for it was the O line, with the O standing for okruh, meaning loop. The only publicly accessible segment of the Prague metro where the train goes under the open sky is between the Skalka and Depo Hostivař stations on the A line. The Prague metro was featured in a commercial for the Apple Watch Series 5. I'll leave a link in the description if you're interested. As of early October 2023, Jiřího z Poděbrad is the only closed Prague metro station. All the other ones are thankfully open. The D metro line, which is currently under construction, will be the first automated metro line in Prague. The D line will also be the first Prague metro line to be fitted with platform screen doors on every station, making playing subway surfers in real life impossible. A test run of platform screen doors is currently under construction in the Zličín station on the western end of the B line. There's a Facebook page for weird people doing weird stuff on public transport called Divno lidi v MHD, link is in the description. The most expensive paper ticket you can buy for Prague public transit is a 3-day one, which costs 330 crowns or about 13.5 euros. If you travel by train to Prague main train station, Prague Holešovice, Prague Libeň or Prague Masaryk train station, you can get a 20% discount on a ticket to the Prague Zoo. The Czech Railways sells a yearly unlimited travel pass called the ID100, which costs 21,990 crowns or roughly 900 euros. Coincidentally, this is almost exactly the amount of money I paid to get my driver's license. It is prohibited to stand near the front door on a Prague bus, because that blocks the driver's view. The southernmost tram stop in Prague is Čechova štvrť in the Modrany district. In contrast, the northernmost tram stop is Vozovna Kobylisy in the Kobylisy district. The tram network crosses the Vltava River 8 times. You can't bring bicycles on the vast majority of buses in Prague, with the exception of line 147. The oldest train station in Prague is Masaryk train station, opened in 1845. This makes it only slightly older than a lot of American politicians. Earlier in 2023, a reconstruction of the station began in preparation for the new train line to the airport. In contrast, the newest train station as of October 2023 is Praha Zahradní město, opened in 2021. The IPA Pavlova metro and tram station are located in the middle of the Magistrála urban freeway, making it a super, super pleasant place to be, not problematic at all. The Rostily metro station on the Sea Line was called Primátora Vacka before 1990. The name refers to Václav Vacek, a founding member of the Czechoslovak Communist Party. In the movie Casino Royale, all airport scenes were filmed at Prague Václav Havel Airport. One of the southernmost train stations in Prague, Praha Radotín, is undergoing a massive overhaul. As part of the modernization plan, the tracks between Praha Radotín and Praha Smíchov were made quadruple track instead of double track. The maximum speed was also improved to 140 km per hour or 87 miles per hour. Some trams in Prague used to have Wi-Fi, but the project was abandoned in favor of covering the entire metro system with cell and mobile data services. The Škoda 14T tram was designed by Porsche. In my opinion, this is the worst tram running in Prague today. Still not the worst thing that Porsche unleashed onto the Czech Republic though. Prague public transit doesn't have turnstiles. There's a museum of the city's public transit system in the Střešovice district. The Prague castle has its own tram stop, fittingly called Pražský hrad. The Czech language has a slang word for a person who takes pictures and records public transit, most prominently trains. They are called šotouš. On the topic of slang, a train driver is called a Maschinenführer, from the German word. It is possible to book a private tram ride in the city with the T3 coupe tram. The tram is a refurbished luxury Tatra T3 model and features stuff like a bar, wooden floors and more. The experience costs 7,700 crowns or 316 euros per hour. Employees of the Prague Public Transit Company get discounted yearly transit passes. You can take a ride on three historic transit lines throughout Prague as of October 2023. Those are the number 41 and 42 tram lines and the K bus line. A 24-hour ticket for all three costs 300 crowns or 12 euros. As of October 2023, the Prague Public Transit Company is looking for new bus and tram drivers. On the topic of bus and tram drivers, the minimum age of entering either of these two professions is 21 years old. The Prague Public Transit Company went by many names. From 1918 to 1940, it was known under the name Elektrické podniky hlavního města Prahy, or the Electrical Companies of the Capital City of Prague. From 1940 to 1942, the electrical companies were named a German language equivalent of the original name, which was the
Elektrizitätsunternehmungen der Hauptstadt Prag.
Thanks, Germany. It is impossible to walk through an entire metro train on any Prague metro line, because the train cars are separated. A version of the M1 metro train, which runs on the Sea Line, was made for the Venezuelan city of Maracaibo. These were purchased in a time when the Venezuelan currency was worth something. The Prague metro was opened in 1974, but the first plan for an underground railway in the city were proposed as far back as 1898. Václav Havel Airport is currently being served by three regular Prague bus lines, one special airport express bus line, two night bus lines and numerous suburban bus lines. The Czech word for a train conductor is průvodčí, but the plainclothes ticket checkers on other public transit modes are known under a different word, revizor. Not all train lines in Prague are electrified. The Prague main train station has 9 platforms. Prague trams run on standard gauge tracks, which are 1435 mm wide. The D metro line is supposed to have trains which you can fully walk through without exiting, meaning that now, if you're lucky, you will be able to catch a whiff of Braník throughout the whole train. The metro has 3 transfer stations, Můstek for the A and B lines, Muzeum for the A and C lines, and Florence for the B and C lines. In the future, the number of transfer stations is supposed to be expanded to 5, with Pankrác and Náměstí Míru becoming transfer stations for the D line. In 2019, there were 2,342 bus stops in Prague, 1,384 of which were request stops. The Kolbenova station on the B metro line is located 26 meters or 85 feet below the surface. It is possible to buy a ticket for Prague public transport via text message and via an app called Pidlítačka. The Tatra T3 tram model has a top speed of 65 km or 40 miles per hour. In comparison, all Prague metro train models have a top speed of 80 km or roughly 50 miles per hour. Thus, Braslav district in the south of Prague doesn't have any tram service. Every summer, a summer holiday public transport schedule goes into effect, decreasing the frequency of transit. This is due to students of primary and secondary schools having their summer break, meaning that there is less demand for public transport. The smallest bus line number is 100, which goes from Zličín to Václav Havel Airport. In comparison, the largest bus line number is 917, going from Obchodní náměstí to Lipence and only at night. When the Prague metro opened in 1974, it featured turnstiles and the fare was 1 Czechoslovak crown. The line was opened by Gustav Husák, the then first secretary of the Communist Party of Czechoslovakia. The AC Sparta Praha football team's stadium on Letná has its own tram stop named after itself. The stop is named Sparta. Sparta's rival team, SK Slavia Praha, has its own tram stop as well, called Slavia Nádraží Eden. While on the topic of football teams, Slavia's stadium has a tram stop, whereas Sparta's does not. The overall southernmost public transit stop in Prague is a bus stop called Strnady, located in the Zbraslav district. 46 out of 61 stations on the Prague metro are wheelchair accessible. The Prague Public Transit Company operates 26 school bus lines with regular public transportation buses. That means that unlike in the US, children take a standard bus to school, not a big yellow one. Prague hosts an embassy of the DPRK in the Petřiny district, close to the Větrník tram stop. If you're in the mood to get put on Kim's watch list, you can get to it with the tram lines 1, 2 during the day and 91 and 96 during the night. Children under 15, seniors over 65 and disabled people travel for free on Prague's public transit. During World War II, trams in Prague started running during the night as well. Because of the risk of drawing the attention of bombers, the lights were turned off. On the topic of World War II, the trams kept running through the war until May 1945, partially thanks to the fact that Prague was relatively lightly bombed compared to the other cities. The Davidská station on the A metro line is 11 meters or 36 feet below the surface. This is the sound that plays before an announcement in a station is made. The Prague metro was put out of service for a while in 2002 due to massive flooding that hit the whole country. In 2022, fares covered roughly 16% of the costs of running public transport in the city. Before 2020, fares covered 21% of the costs. On the 1st of August 2021, the 30-minute transit tickets price rose from 24 Czech crowns to 30, and the 90-minute tickets price rose from 32 crowns to 40. The new prices are 1.23 and 1.64 euros respectively. Prague main train station was originally called Emperor Franz Josef train station. From 1919 to 1940, it was called Wilson train station after US President Woodrow Wilson. From 1940 to 1945, it was known as Prague main train station. After liberation, it was known as Wilson train station until 1953. After 1953, it took on the name of Prague main train station again, and the name sticks to this day. The Prague metro was supposed to be an underground tram before it was decided that it's going to be a full heavy metro. As of the 6th of October, there were 2 fatal collisions of trams and pedestrians in 2023. The Globus department store in Zličín used to run its own private bus line from the Zličín metro station. This private service was replaced by city buses 130 and 246. One of the terminus stations of the C metro line, Haye, used to be named Kosmonautu, after Soviet and Czechoslovak astronauts. After the fall of the previous regime, the station was renamed to Haye, but a square near the station still bears the name Namiesti Kosmonautu, meaning Square of the Astronauts. In the late 19th and early 20th century, trams ran across the historical Charles Bridge. Thank you so much for watching to the end. You are a legend. This has been Tramly, and I'll see you next week. Bye!